Shavua Tov. Okay. I think you got an idea what this video is about. It's official. We got our approval. We got our flights booked. It's happening.
Yes.
What day?
We are moving October 8th.
Woo!
Prayer does work. It works. And we got our approval. What day was that?
Tuesday. So this past Tuesday, we got the approval. Came in at like 3 something in the morning. And like I woke up in the morning.
Woke me up.
I woke her up. I was like, babe, we got approved. And I was screaming like low because the kids were...
That's why we're not even talking loud now, because the kids are asleep, and then the kids were asleep at 3 in the morning. Yeah.
So we were obviously ecstatic, going crazy, and we still are, obviously. This has been a couple day
celebration,
process, build up. And we've been so excited to be able to just share this news with you guys, because one of our last videos, we were talking about, just us planning and living like we were gonna leave already.
Yeah.
You know,
packing up. Our house is a mess right now. It's getting empty. Like you saw our video with the bookshelves, right? And taking out all the books and getting the things off of there. And so we have just been living our life, like you said, as if or not even knowing what flight we're gonna get on or if we for sure are even leaving during these times. And so you might have heard us talk about, we've been talking about, September 23rd or September 25th. That is the flight that we were going to be on. Right. We kept saying 23rd, 25th. And we actually were looking at those flights from the moment like we started the Aliyah process.
Back in January.
Because we saw like, hey, we had to be in a, we had to wait for our official meeting with the Jewish agency 9 months after our conversion. So after like 9 months of converting, we had to wait, which was August 5th. And so that was our 9 month. And so we were just like, we see September.
That's it.
That's the one. We're getting on that one.
So on the day of our approval on Tuesday, we're on the phone with our advisor and we're trying to figure things out. And they're like, okay, what flight? And we're like, September 23rd. So that's
how 25th, we said.
25th.
We said September 25th.
25th.
Yes.
So then he's like, well, according to what I'm seeing now, it's booked. And we're like, okay, 23rd.
Yeah. We saw that one open up, and that one just opened up a month ago.
Right.
And so we were like, perfect. We have another option just in case.
Then he's like, I don't know, because this one looks pretty full too. So we're like, listen, Shem.
You got us this far.
We want to be there. For the Chagim. We want to be there. And so he's like, just talk to the flight department. They're going to email you. And so,
also, too, they were just saying like, we just don't want you guys to have your hopes high right now.
Right.
Your expectations. Because, honestly, it looks like probably October 30th is the next one out showing on Nefesh for Nefesh from LAX.
Right.
It's October 30th. We was like, and I, after I heard that the flights were booked, I said, Nope. Because I know Hashem wouldn't have got us this far. Gave us approval. We got the Aliyah approval, the Mazel Tov letter. I'm like, Hashem, you wouldn't get us this far to not be there for the High Holy Days. So I'm like, we just got to pray a little bit more. We got to talk to Hashem. We got to trust and believe. And then.
Yeah. And so then the next day, which I think was Wednesday, I'm going back and forth with the flight department. And so they sent me an email. It was like, okay, well, does October 8th work? And we like, yes, if there's nothing sooner, then absolutely 100%, let's get it.
I'm like, we'll be here for Rosh Hashanah, that's fine. But if we're there for Yom Kippur and Sukkot, we have to feel Yom Kippur and Sukkot.
Yes.
Like we have to.
We've heard it is next level.
Feel that. So that was just like our prayer. And so they said October 8th. And this is not even like... It's not even a posted flight yet, or on Nefesh B'Nefesh. So we were like, we'll take it. October 8th, we'll take it. And then we also, looked at the significance of, it's literally the day after October 7th, right? Which is, it's mind-blowing that we're going on a year. And please God, let our hostages be released even before that date. And all of this craziness ends. But I just looked at that like, wow, we're coming the next day. Like,
yeah. So our flight
is the 8th, but our flight gets in on the 9th, actually. Yeah. So
we're obviously incredibly excited. You know, we just look back and we can see Hashgacha Pratit in full effect. And, you know, I've learned so much from my wife in not wavering with our Emuna, with our Bitachon.
That's right.
And it was just like, I see my wife during this whole process and she's like, she wouldn't take no for an answer. and it's just been, and it's not, I wasn't doubting or whatever, but there are times where like, we get tired. There's frustration now. So I was frustrated at, you know, at certain points, but just to be able to have that, that strength from my wife, just to see her, you know, it's just like, no, she's like immovable. Like she doesn't move at all. She doesn't budge and she's firm. And she's like, no, I believe Hashem's going to do it. You know, so I just want to thank you, you know, for just your strength and your belief and that, that consistency. It helps me so much. Mm. You're amazing.
Thank you. I mean, honestly, Hashem has showed up in our life so much.
Right.
Hashem is showing up in all of our lives, guys. If we actually sit back and we take the those moments, and sometimes we look at the small things and don't realize that's such a big thing. And to other people, it is a big thing. So I think that, you know, that has allowed me to really grow even more in trusting Hashem and not wavering. I'm just like, Hashem is the creator of the entire universe, of the entire world. Like, he can do anything at any moment. And I believe that wholeheartedly. I believe it so much. I've seen him come through and just do amazing things in our life. And I think when you have that level of Emuna, like, Hashem has to show up for you. So I look, I'm like, you have to show up. Like, I'm trusting, I'm believing you're going to show up. Yeah. So,
A good friend of ours, Rabbi Kalmus, Rabbi David Kalmus, he told me recently, he said, you know, if you want to know what real Emuna looks like, you can find it in a Jewish woman. If you want to know what Emuna with Bitachon looks like, you can find it there, right? And so it's amazing. So we're coming. We're coming. We're on our way. And
see you.
We can't wait. There's a lot to this story. There's so many incredible, crazy moments throughout this whole thing. We're going to share everything. Mm-hmm. We're going to share everything. But we wanted to make sure we got a message out to you guys. I've just got out of Shabbat. We had a beautiful, beautiful Shabbat. We hope all of you guys had a beautiful Shabbat as well.
Mm-hmm. We got to host actually our rabbi and our Rebbetzin, which amazing. It was actually our last time being able to host because actually we're selling our table and we're only going to have like a foldable table. So it was so beautiful to be able to end our last hosting, you know, with our rabbi and our Rebbetzin. And
so beautiful.
They are amazing. Amazing people. We love them so much, so dearly. We're going to miss them so much. And
big shout out to the Senior family.
Yeah.
Senior,
special family.
Special Natalie Senior. Mm-hmm. We love you guys dearly. So, so, so much. And then they gave us the opportunity to be able to share. We did. We spoke after Sudash Lishit tonight. Mm-hmm. And it was absolutely amazing. Yeah, it was absolutely amazing. So more videos to come. Stay tuned. We're going to take you on the journey, right? When we get to Eretz Yisrael, the videos are going next level. We're just getting started.
Oh,
get
yes. Oh, the vlogging, we're upping it up on the vlog style.
So, it's official. October 8th, the Hart family, we're coming to Eretz Yisrael. 23 days, we flying out of here.
So let the countdown begin now.